Hello and welcome to another Overlord Lore video, and today we are going to take an in-depth look at the power levels of the new world. But before we do so, let me thank my patrons for supporting this channel. Now let's start this video off with a bit of historic context. More than 600 years ago, prior to the appearance of the six great gods, humanity was a fading species on the verge of extinction. Only the six players of the theocracy and the advent of tier magic ensured our survival. The eight great kings who appeared 500 years before Nezurik and 100 years after the six great gods of the theocracy have almost wiped out the dragon lords, and many other powerful species were also brought to the brink of extinction, or indeed further. Therefore, the average level of the new world being went down quite a bit, with the civil war of the eight great kings reducing it even further, since now the last major power had wiped out itself, or was wiped out by Platinum Dragonlord and his remaining kin in the aftermath of the civil war. The next big thing happened 200 years before Nezurik, with the appearance, or rather the invasion, of the evil spirits, who destroyed many nations and quite likely killed millions of individuals, which might have actually raised the level of the average New Worlder, at least in the known New World, since now it wasn't populated by as much weak people as before. But this likely only lasted until the population recovered, and most of the 13 heroes died. The next big change was the appearance of Nezurik, and the foundation of the Sorcerer Kingdom. Alongside of the near total destruction of the Kingdom of Riestheis, and the invasion of the northern half of the Holy Kingdom, with the loss of so many human lives, most of them civilians, and the creation of 20,000 mid-tier undead, alongside the appearance of the Great Tomb itself and its many powerful inhabitants, the average level of the New Worlder likely went up a bit, because many strong entities emerged and battled a relatively weak part of the New World. Now with this bit of history out of the way, let's take a look at the ranking. All of this was originally confirmed by the author himself, but I added a few beings here and there to cover a wider range of levels. At the very bottom we find Nemu Emot, a human child who is weaker than even the average human. And an average human would be weaker, and this is the author speaking, than a tiger. And stronger than a wild tiger is a tame dog, aka Climb, who in turn is weaker than Zarayusu Sasha, the Lizardman Wanderer. After them we encounter a wall, a level cap of 20, which is likely present because it is the original level cap in Dungeons & Dragons, Pathfinder, and similar pen and paper frameworks. And normal persons are unable to breach this wall with sheer effort and will alone. They have to be gifted, or aided, in some way or another to get through it. After the wall we encounter Zero, the leader of the Six Arms, who is weaker than Gargaran, the virgin slayer of Blue Roses, who in turn lost to Brain Anglaus during the Royal Tournament. And Brain Anglaus is weaker than Gazev Stronov, without his treasury gear equipped, likely because of his one level in Cook. And Gazev Stronov is, generally speaking, weaker than Ein Zulgaun's pet hamster, Hamuske. And yes, she will get her own video and an explanation of the Hamuske conspiracy. But for now, keep in mind that Clementine, even in her bikini armor, is stronger than both Gazev and Hamuske. Though she would still lose against Gazev in his treasure gear. But in turn, Gazev would lose against Clementine in her black scripture outfit. And between Gazev and Clementine, there exists another barrier, the Realm of Heroes, aka level 30. While some gifted individuals can breach the first wall and go beyond even level 20, almost no one, not even Gazev, can reach this mythical realm without any aid. But Clementine was one of the very, very few people of the new world who was naturally in it. But even the agile, nimble and fast ex-Black Scripture member in her gear isn't a match for Solution Epsilon, who also has access to high-level equipment, but has nearly double the amount of levels Clementine has. But here's the thing, even Solution Epsilon, one of the strongest battlemates, isn't as strong as the lead of the Black Scripture, a young Godkin, who potentially has everything it takes to become even stronger than he currently is. Now, being stronger than Solution Epsilon, aka level 60, at a bare minimum, is something only a handful of entities can claim. But Zeshi the Half-Elf Godkin is most certainly among these circles, because she is even stronger than the Godkin that leads the Black Scripture. Hence, while she holds an extra seat in it, and she probably did so for decades, but it seems that even Zeshi isn't a match for Platinum Dragonlord's true body, which is said to be the strongest entity in the new world. At least according to Rigrid Bears-Karu. Last but not least, there's also a different power scaling Nezurik came up with. It sorts 99% of all beings in the new world in the first category of level 1 to level 40. And this category is aptly named as Useless Weaklings, while those of level 40 to level 70 are seen as worthy of attention, and they are usually characters involved in major events. Perhaps the Godkin that leads the Black Scripture would fall into this category, albeit in the upper half of it. And the last category is for all beings over the level of 70, and it contains all beings worthy of remembrance, which thus far might only contain the 5 Dragonlords of the Arklind Council State, Cure-Elim, and Zeshi, as well as such legendary figures as the 8 Greed Kings, the 6 Great Gods, the Minotaur Sage, the Dragon Emperor, and perhaps even more players such as the Goblin King, who battled and defeated dragons with an ash branch, and maybe even the Demonic Tree defeated by the Floor Guardians in the Forest of Top, in one of the side stories. Last but not least, the evil deities might fit into all categories at the same time, the weakest of them being nothing but fodder, where the mid-tier were taken out by Evil Eye and other members of the 13 heroes, while Platinum Dragonlord's armor battled the strongest evil spirits. But again, these are just my thoughts where the evil deities would fit in Nezurik's power scale. And with that said, let me say thank you very much for watching, and special thanks to Adam J, Al Capone, Andy, Angel of Death, Bad Guy Yee, Ben C, Boyzilla, Chrissy, Conquer All, Death is Mercy, Diabetic Centaur, Dystopia, Elika Birchleaf, Phaelis Katus, Ferrachivan, Forbus Gurupulon, Gigafight, Ghost of Epicness, Hector Marino, Black Phoenix Emperor, Hoss, Huster, Janna B, Jason, Kleinator, Chromius, Lart, Lifar, Legendarius, Lord Nishikian Rai, Lord Touch Me, Lord Ulbatalane Odol, Lucas Oli, Laxus Fox, Majima, Matt, Matt C, Marcos, Michael R, Mr. Shoes, Mindless Wrath, Menu 13, Mirtis, Nfirias Potion, Okill, Primus 11, Sasuga Einsama, Sebastian, Shadow Lightning Wolf, Search, Spark the Unicorn, Sunlight, The Orc Warboss Rock Adsmasher, Ultrasuck, Vash Hawkeye, Zogo Bane of a Lot, and Zonagon. Thanks, guys. Anyway, have a nice day, over and out.